Match game 74, production number 0145, air date to be announced, BT Yard 1974. It's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Meredith McRae, Richard Dawson, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
For joining us here today. Something I neglected to point out is that we've reunited Charles and Orson.
Oh, yes.
You guys have known each other for a long time.
We're the original odd couple.
I want to know is, when are you going to reunite Jack and me?
I don't know about that. We have no plans to do that.
No, but we were in acting school together.
Whose class was that?
22 years ago.
No, don't say the date.
Uta Hagen.
Uda Hagen. Best actresses in the world and one of the best acting teachers.
Good teacher.
Although in our case, we didn't work out well.
You guys both turned out okay. You know, the thing that Charles did for a long time, which I understand is in reruns, I haven't seen it, is The Ghost and Mrs. Muir, and you were delightful in that. Is that still going?
Show. Yes, we're on all over the country.
What's wrong? Is anything wrong down here?
Well, tell about... I was in her first play on TV.
My very first
Her very job. First words.
What was that?
After selling bed sheets and all the really fun stuff, I did my first job with Charles Nelson Reilly.
And it was a joy.
She was a waitress, right?
Yes, I was. Ended up on the cutting room floor.
All right, I think our celebrities are all ready to have a go at it. Let's say hello to our current champion, Virginia Shook, who's won $700 so far. How are you?
I'm fine. Now,
you got two games under your belt.
That means
you're going to have another go at the audience match in which you can win over $5,000. We're going to get to that, Virginia, right after we get to this message of importance for you. Come back. Here we go with Virginia Shook. $700 to her credit. She's going to have a go at over $5,000 now. Good luck to you, Virginia. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank fly. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response is $250 if you match that one. And if you match the third one, it's $100. All right, straighten out, y'all. There's camera crew here. And fly right here now.
Just don't ask Richard, Virginia.
Now, you get a little help from our celebrities, namely three.
Brett.
I say housefly.
Housefly is one.
Oh,
another one?
Watch it now.
Richard.
Superfly.
Superfly.
Fly like soup.
Yes, Superfly, he say.
Orson.
And Orson.
El Señor.
Go ahead. Say, give us your hand.
Take one of mine, Orson.
Go ahead.
Horse.
Horsefly, he says. So you have
Check
a horsefly, you have a housefly, and you've got a superfly. You may choose one of those, or give us one of your own if you'd like. What do you say?
I'm just going to go for superfly.
Superfly, you think, is it? She thinks superfly is under the big response there. We're going to find out right now if it is indeed up there at all. First, may we see the $100 response? Horsefly is up there, is the one that Orson gave you. Very good. Still looking for Superfly. Here is a $250 response. Butterfly is a good one. We didn't think of that, did we, dummies?
Kind of a minty crowd that day.
Yes.
I was in pink and I thought of a sweet butterfly.
Yeah, you thought of a butterfly.
But no one called on me.
No one called on you.
I won't tell you what he wrote on his card.
Here is the third and last chance to see if you're going to get your Superfly. Here is the $500 response. Superfly, you've got it. You've got it. Very good, Richard. You can thank old Richard for giving you that one. Well done. All right. So you got the $500. That means you will now play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. And to collect, remember, you got to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, has to be exact. Remember that. You face me. Richard will write his response to this, if you would, please. Bob Blank. Bob Blank. He's finished his response. Virginia, we need your answer. How do you fill in the blank? Bob?
Exactly what I'm doing. Hope.
Bob Hope. Hope. You're hoping that he's written the same
right
thing.
Right now.
All right, we'll find out right now for $5,000, Richard. Sir, may we see your answer?
Well, so they don't get violent, a bob in England is a shilling.
Is it what?
It's a shilling.
It's a shilling. Yeah. That's right. It's a denomination.
The only, you know, I just hope that I didn't upset you.
Program, and I love them.
They're the ones who wrote in?
They're the ones who wrote in and said their mother ought to be on.
And here she is. And she's got the money. She's up there. You what?
I said I'd meet you.
Well, you've done that. We congratulate you. Virginia, you're up to $6,200. You're going to play another game against John Paul Scott. Here he comes. Hello, John. Can't wait. You know Virginia, John?
John.
She just went for the whole bundle. John, we welcome you
Thank you.
Wish you the best of luck and ask you to tell us a little bit about John Paul Scott. That's a great name.
Thank you. I work for a national retail hardware chain, and I have a beautiful wife, Connie, and a daughter, too, named Jennifer.
Okay. Good luck to you here. Are you ready to have a go at it?
Ready.
Okay. Here's the button I push, and that reveals two questions, and you as a challenger will make a selection, if you would, please.
I'll take A.
He wants A. You ready? Okay, everybody plays.
Yes, yes.
Bernice said.
Yes.
George.
Yes.
You were really disgusting last night when my friends were over. All you did was sit in the corner and blank. Bernice said. George, you were really disgusting last night when my friends were over. All you did was sit in the corner and... Okay. Everybody ready down here, Brett?
I'm not down there. I'm up here. Oh, you mean everyone's ready down there?
That's right.
Oh, yes, I understand.
Now, John, Bernice said, George, you were really disgusting last night when my friends were over. All you did was sit in the corner and...
Sleep.
Sleep. You like that? Sleep. I suppose that would be a disgusting thing to do at a party when everybody was being very gay. Orson, what do you say?
Wouldn't disgust me. Drink.
Drink. Drink would never disgust you, would it, Brett?
You can swing that in ragtime, sweetheart.
What do you say?
For all those people in America who think that Jack Klugman is a swinger, snore.
Snore and sleep, is that a match?
That's it.
That is a match. That is a match. All right. May we hear the dinger? We didn't hear it because the audience was there.
Would you mind?
There is it. Thank you very much. Charles.
I said pout.
Pout. All you did was sit in the corner and pout. Sleep is the answer that he is looking for. And what do you say?
Well, I went along with Orson and I said drink.
Drink. Okay. That seems to be the popular favorite there. How about you, sir?
Well, if that's the popular favorite. This guy, you know, he sat in the corner and...
Burp. Burp.
Because he's been drinking all night.
That is disgusting behavior.
I wasn't
sleep is the answer he's looking for. He's matched once. Marcia, what do you say to that?
Drink.
Drink. Okay. So we had a lot of booze there, John. One match for you, and we'll have a question for you after we have this message for you.
GSN presents...
Gene Reavers!
There was a very attractive young woman contestant on the show. I was trying to compliment her on her beautiful smile, and I looked right into her eyes and I said, you know, you have the most beautiful nipples I've ever seen.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
I really wanted the earth to open up and swallow me right then and there because I was embarrassed.
Here we go. We finished one half of round one. John scored one match, and now we've got this for Virginia, our current champion. Are you ready, folks? Here
yep.
we go.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, what?
Last night.
Yes.
Kathy made $100.
Mercy.
Oh, wee!
Yeah. Ah!
Before tax.
I haven't made $100.
Quiet. Last night, Kathy made $100 selling blank door to door. Door to door. Don't pay any attention to the audience. Just listen to what I'm saying to you. Last night, Kathy made $100 selling blank door to door. Nothing to it, Orson. Just give us your second answer. Okay. All right. Everybody ready down here? We're all set.
I hate Orson's ass.
Virginia. Last night, Kathy made $100 selling blank door to door.
I can only think of one word. Herself. I'm sorry, Mother.
What did you say?
I said, I'm sorry, Mother.
She said she's sorry, Mother. Well, that's her answer. What do you say, Orson?
Door to door breaks it down to a rather poor price, doesn't it?
Sure do.
$1.50 from Tuesday to Thursday.
All right, let's get on with it now. Orson, may we see your card,
yes,
please?
Yes, jams and jellies. I couldn't think
jams
of anything.
Jams and jellies is a splendid answer. Brett.
That woman's children got her on this show.
That's right.
How do you think you got the children?
Where are your children tonight, Virginia?
Does anybody have a hanky?
Yes, cry a little
is
bit, but show us your
the
answer.
Daughter wants B all the time?
Yeah, no, that's another one.
B girl.
No, come on now. Brett?
I said dictionaries.
Dictionaries is a good answer. Charles?
I love
all right now.
Anyone in pink would love an answer like jams and jellies, but I said love for sale.
Love
same
for sale.
Thing.
One. What do you say?
Well, I wasn't dirty this time, Gene. I said hello. Raffle tickets.
Raffle tickets, door to door.
Yes,
all right.
But what kind?
Here comes the
kind.
Show us your answer that says Girl Scout cookies, Richard.
Never.
I do remember someone saying, who gave you the quarter? And she said, all of them. I said, kissing.
Marcia.
Gene.
Yes. Marcia.
Gene.
Oh, Marcia.
Gene.
Oh, Marcia.
Magazine Where, subscriptions.
Oh, Marcia.
You never promised you a rose garden
for Okay, so the score is 1-1 at the end of round one. And we go to round two here and ask John to make a selection. John Paul,
B.
I beg your pardon.
Yeah, I'll take B this time.
He wants B. Right. Now, let's see. You matched one person. You matched Brett, so Brett, you will not participate. He doesn't want anybody to know this, but Jeffrey,
yes,
the guard at Buckingham Palace,
oh,
hides a blank in his big furry hat. You know, the Buckingham Palace guards, you know, the big furry hats. Well,
we
Jeffrey,
don't, dear. Do you know?
Hides a blank in his big furry hat.
I lay out this time.
Yes, you do. That's Jeffrey, G-E-O-F-F-R-E-Y. Ready here and there.
And everywhere.
Oh, my God. I cannot work under this pressure.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
Okay. All right, Charles, here we go. John Paul. He doesn't want anybody to know this, but Jeffrey the guard at Buckingham Palace hides a blank in his big furry hat.
I'll say bottle.
A bottle. Have you ever been applauded by 100 winos? There they are. They love your answer there. Orson, he said bottle.
Jeffrey the guard hides a big furry head in that big furry hat. No, a jug, a bottle.
Jug, a bottle. There's a mat. Okay, one for you, John Paul. And
well,
Charles.
Well, I said sandwich. I'm sorry.
Sandwich is good. Nothing wrong with that.
Don't throw anything.
How about you, dear girl?
Well, somehow I said a gun.
A gun? He hides a gun there. And how about you?
Well, when he's on duty, he holds a bottle up and says, hold. No, I happen to know he did have a bottle.
A bottle up there. Marcia.
Gene.
Yes.
It's only because you rushed me, but I think I've done it again.
What?
A pizza.
Marcia. My must have gotten a little gamey up there after a couple of weeks, sir.
I have not raised my hand because I want to leave the room.
Why have you raised your hand?
I just want to reiterate, I do not want to be attacked anymore on this show.
Okay, we'll keep Marcia around so nobody attacks you. The score at this moment is 3-1. We're in the middle of round two, and we've got to deliver a message here, but we're going to get right back to you and talk to you right after this message. Here we go. Middle of round two. Got a question for you. The score at this moment is 3-1. You got to match two to stay in the running. Three, however, will win another game for you, Virginia. You match
Chuck.
Chuck's here in the pink. Sorry. Chuck. I'll call you Chuck from now on.
Gotten so butch since she's come back from New York, there's no living with him.
Quiet! As Tiny Tim tiptoed through the tulips, he tripped on his blank. As Tiny Tim tiptoed through the tulips, he tripped on his blank. He tripped on his blank. Oh, everybody up there is ready. How about you down here? Think of Tiny Tim.
Yes.
He's tiptoeing through the tulips. Okay, they're all ready over there. Virginia, as Tiny Tim tiptoed through the tulips, he tripped on his...
ukulele.
His ukulele. Ukulele. Okay, that seems like a reasonable response to me. Does it seem reasonable to you? Very good imitation of a ukulele. Very good, there's one man. One more to tie, two to win. Brett.
Well, if I'd been thinking of Dickens, I probably would have said crutch, but I wasn't. So I said skirt.
Tiny Tim tripped on his skirt. Yes, of course.
Or caftan, as the case may be.
All right. Yes, anything you say. Meredith, would you?
Oh, I was waiting for Charles. Sorry.
Show and tell.
Well, I just love him and Miss Vicky, and I said ukulele.
Score is tied. You got two celebrities to go. One more match will win another game for you, Virginia. Richard.
Tiptoe through the
tree. There, that wins the game. What do you got? And there's another ukulele. Would I kid you? There's another game for you and another $100 for you. And we've got to say goodbye to John Paul Scott. It was a short meeting, but a very pleasant one
for
us. I hope you enjoyed it, John.
Very much so.
Good. We've got a gift for John Paul Scott backstage. Thank you, sir. Goodbye. This lady now has $6,300 to her credit. And she's going to have another go at over $5,000 here in the Big Money Super Match. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank Jack. You know how it goes? 500 and 250 and 100 and a little help from celebrities. You want to choose them one at a time now?
I'll go Charles.
Charles!
Okay. Let's go with... Jumping.
Oh. Jumping Jack. If he wanted to say Jumping Jack Orson, you let him say Jumping Jack and leave him alone.
And if I want to say,
I was going to say Hi, Jack, but when you talk about butterflies and wear a pink sweater, you don't use such words.
I see.
Meredith.
Meredith, what is your response here?
I would say Blackjack.
Blackjack?
Oh, that's good.
One more.
Richard Dawson.
Richard Dawson.
A man who's very close to me, Billy Jack.
Billy Jack. So you've got
Billy
Jack, Black Jack, and Jumping Jack. Remember, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you want to do?
I like to gamble. I'll go with Black Jack.
Black Jack it is. That's the one we're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Jumping Jack is up there, and you've already had that from Charles. Still looking for Black Jack. Here's a $250 response. Billy Jack is up there. You got two out of three. Here is a good omen. Maybe it's up there. Here is the $500 response. Black Jack.
Oh, she did it for you.
All right, we'll come back to her in a moment or so. We got this message for you right now. Virginia Shook will be back next time to have a go at the big money here, and we'll see how that works out. Hope you'll be able to join us. You were just terrific. I mean terrific. And I thank you all. And I hope you can all come back again sometime.
When?
Soon.
We'd love to.
Yeah, don't finish that.
All right. But next week, we're going to have this bunch of cuckoo birds.
Larry Hobus. Rhett Summers. Rich Taylor. Joanne Flew. Richard Dawson. And Peggy Katz.
Team Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister. Designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air. Fiberglass reinforced construction, strong, lightweight luggage by American Tourister. And a supply of AeroWax with acrylic and wax. For the ruggedness of acrylic, the rich, warm glow of wax in one great shine, AeroWax. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes. So quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next on the most of the CBS station.